So hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. I actually started doing this video and realized my camera was not recording, so we're popping back in here. This morning I've just been feeling like a little off. I've been feeling a little down, a little sad, multiple things happening, and I really decided I needed to get my mindset right, and I wanted to show the little ritual I do for myself when I have mornings like this to help me process emotionally. It's one of the most beautiful things that I've learned, and I just want to share it because hopefully this will be meaningful for somebody else. I apologize for why I said that. So first of all, I wrote in today's date, but the first thing that I was super grateful for was just waking up to my body being whole and feeling alive. And yes, I woke up with this like kind of anxious energy in the pit of my stomach and just not feeling quite right. But I was alive and I had all my limbs, all my arms. I just held myself and hugged myself and said, thank you for another day of being here. And may I spend it wisely and on my mission. May I spend this day not living for other people, but for something, or myself, but for something that has a bigger purpose. And may everything that I do move towards that goal of making the world better, of making myself better, of being a good steward and making the world better around me, and continually moving my life forward so that I can be of better service, and how can I support myself better so that I can serve more. So that's the very thing that drives me. But this morning I was just so grateful to wake up and just feel my body and just feel alive and know that my body, I have all my limbs. Yes, I was feeling sad and anxious, but at the end of the day, those were just emotions that I need to move through, and I have so much available to me, and it was okay to be sad, and it was okay to feel that, and I really allowed myself to feel that this morning, just walk with it. So what I did is I wrote a beautiful letter to myself, which I won't share here, it's a little too personal. I took a really nice warm shower, which is going to lead me to my second thing that I'm grateful for. In the shower, you know, it's just like feeling that water flowing over my body. It just feels so good and so beautiful. I mean, what a blessing to just be able to walk like a short bit and have nice hot water to the temperature that I desire. I mean, modernity, it's crazy. Like, we have all these things in our day-to-day that we take so for granted because they're just there and they become invisible to us, and we forget to appreciate them and really like fully enjoy them and immerse in them, and they can be so quickly gone. So just in the shower, just like feeling that water running over me, feeling the soap and just drifting away, I had so many beautiful revelations. I felt like this another massive explosion of light internally. And I just got out of the shower and I was just giggling like euphorically. I was so happy. Well, actually, I've turned the water to cold, which felt so good, just having cold water on myself. And it felt amazing. So I got out and I'm like giggling hysterically and in like a good way, euphorically is the better word. And I was just so happy. And it's just like that beautiful moment, those little things, just pausing and really feeling deeply into them. They're everything. But as long as our mind is wandering in its victim story and the world hates me and everything's wrong around me and everything's bad and my life sucks, I give up on myself, I'm broken, blah, 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 whatever our brain all wants to tell us, you know. When we're stuck in that space, we can't truly stop and appreciate all the things that we do have around us. And we can't really feel, and the key word is feel them deeply. So a lot of my channel will be focused on somatic healing, which is really sinking in and feeling life and slowing down so that you can actually start tuning in to your deeper emotions, tuning into how things feel, because when you really focus on how something feels, it changes your perspective on life. And it's often we get numb and we can, everything kind of passes over us, and we want things that give us like these quick fixes and hits of this euphoria, but we're seeking them in the wrong places. We're not allowing them to come at the height of the music and enjoying the process to getting there. We want everything instant. We don't want to do the work and like wait for the reward. And sometimes the process itself is more sweet. I mean, when you think about, for example, if you use sex, like some people get so focused on the orgasm itself, the peak, the height of it, that they forget all the little stuff in between there. And that doesn't even just in the bedroom, that's outside the bedroom. The teasing texts, the fleeting touches, the hugs, the being there for each other, all those small things, doing sweet things for each other, showing up for each other when another needs a shoulder. All those moments, just like soft, keeping that soft tension, but people get so addicted to the high and the low. They want the drama and then the sex and then the drama and then, you know, sex is just peaking at orgasm versus like very deep, meaningful connection, because that connection itself, really going deep and just really being deep with somebody and emotionally vulnerable, that's hard, because if we can't be emotionally vulnerable with ourselves, we can never find that with anyone else. So my little tangent for a moment. My shower was amazing, so I'm gonna write in. Shower felt incredible. Let's see. Third thing I'm grateful for today. You know what? I gotta say that I'm super grateful for my bird. My bird makes me so happy, and he's teaching me something really amazing. I'll talk about that here in a moment. So I'm going to write my bird. What did my bird is teaching me? When I got my bird, I was so excited. I was at the pet shop and I was like, I can't wait. I'm going to go home. And the bird, me and the bird are going to have so much fun. He's going to climb all over me. He's going to be my finger. It's going to be great. Like, he's going to walk up my arm and be playing all over me. And instead, I get home and I realize, well, I realized at the pet shop, but I really realized when I was home, so the bird was terrified, not only of me, but its new environment, and it needed days to even adjust to that before it was moving and doing things. But on top of that, my bird was terrified. So there was no like, and I understood at the process of like really giving the bird time and space to get used to me, and just being really soft and gentle and soothing voices. And the bird's limbic system is programmed, so you know that they're... things are predatory until the bird figures out, because it's a bird that predators eat, until the bird figures out that you're not a threat and you're okay and you're not gonna harm it, it takes a lot of time, months. And in that, the bird's just really making me realize, like, I have to, again, it's a lesson of delayed gratification and really enjoying the process until the bird, you know, will bring me that much joy, because we have some stuff to work through before then. First, we have to be like, we're cool with each other, you know? So yeah, it's been quite a process, but I love what the bird's teaching me. So I very, very much appreciate that. And wow, I'm already on 9 minutes. Good to know. We are gonna move along. So my goal to live fit life fit today, live life or fit today, is, you could choose one of these. I don't know. The wording's a little funny, but I get the point. So what is my goal today? My goal today is just to honor my emotional space. And at the same time, focus on what I'm grateful for. And what is going right. Honor my emotional space. So what I mean by that is, I'm going to do extra movement today. I'm going to do yoga. I'm going to go walk, take a nice little walk at the park this evening. Maybe even put in my earbuds and music and play some basketball. Just, it helps calm my mind so much. We'll definitely be doing a hot salt bath later today. And just all things where I will take time to really sink into my body and really tell my body it's okay, I'm here for it. You know, this is a process. And my emotions are just that, they're emotions, they don't run my life, they simply are, and I'm going to be in the process of those out, and without externalizing it anywhere, and really focus on the lessons that each one of those brings, and also training my body this happens over time, you get to train your body that it's okay to hold those emotions. It gets stronger. It's like building a muscle. It's like you build your biceps. You can build your ability to, your emotional capacity can grow. So one thing I appreciate about my strong body today, I'm going to say I appreciate the fact that it can process that many neurotransmitters and still be alive. It's great, right? I mean, the resilience our body has. So I'm going to fill this out and then I'm going to journal. This journal part's going to be a little personal. This is going to be talking about, you know, I'm going to write about my fears and what's coming up, why it logically doesn't make sense and what trauma that might be doing. So I might make a little map here. Whatever that looks like, I'm going to make that really cool and beautiful. And then I'm going to write a little inspirational message to myself. The reason I'm not going to do anything more is because I won't torture you with a many hours long video, or it's not going to be hours, it'll be like another 10 minutes, but we'll stop here. You kind of get the idea of what I do. I super appreciate you being here with me today, and I look forward to doing many more of these videos. If you want to hit subscribe and like and the bell button so you get notifications when I upload videos, that would be amazing. I would love to have your thoughts, your input, you joining me on this journey, and to hear your experience, what you do to make your emotional mental health better and more well. So thank you so much for joining me.